guys, we are back.
And you'll be happy to know, hopefully you can hear us. Let us know if you can hear us. I think we fixed our mics. We mic'd up, we figured out our mic issue.
We had some issues.
Yeah, so fixed. Let us know.
Fixed.
Hopefully. That's what we're going to find out. Can you hear us? Give us a thumbs up. Give a thumbs
we
up.
We have four guests
if
already.
You can hear us.
Yes. Thumbs up. Hi.
Hi, Marley. Marley, can you hear us? Give us a thumbs up if you can hear us.
Two thumbs up. I see them.
Woo-woo! Okay.
I can hear you. Excellent.
Yay!
Welcome, everyone. We are going to do...
this time, you guys. I'm going to drink it. We fixed our tripod, so no
more
camera shake. So we've got a nice view on what we're doing. I won't be walking around like a goofball. So yeah, we're all good now. Hey, loud and clear. Yay. Oh my goodness. I cleaned up my wax.
Welcome, everyone. Okay, so now is the fun part.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's my favorite part,
and it's
pulling
it
the paper
so satisfying.
And leaving the pigment in that coat of paint.
Yes.
So we're going to use a couple of things. I have a water bottle, just a spritz water bottle, and I have some shop towels that are in a little tub with a little water, so they're nice and damp.
Mm-hmm.
Because before we pull these, we want to make sure that they are thoroughly damp. Okay, that dampness is going to activate the fibers and the pigment in both the base coat and the inlay in order to let it release easily. Your paper should never need enough tension to tear it. If it is tearing, that means it's not
too
dampy
much.
Enough.
Yeah.
Exactly. So we're going to go ahead and get right to that. Let's start. And because we have a nice section here all in one piece, we're going to dampen the whole thing
mm-hmm.
before we start pulling this. And I want to tell you why. If we pull this one first and then we go to dampen this one, then we have to be aware of the revealed pigment next to it and not smearing that.
Mm.
So rather than do that one at a time, we wet it all, then we pull it all. It's kind of like the age-old question. Do you put on a sock and then a shoe and then a sock and then a shoe? Or do you put both socks and then both shoes?
I feel like it's totally different than that.
Whatever. I feel like it's like that. So we're going to put on both socks and then both shoes.
I guess if your socks were made of paint, it would smear if you got wet. Hey.
Okay. Let's go ahead and this is how you'll get on and get on there. Just really get it damp. However, it is actually quicker and easier with a nice wet, not dripping, but amply wet, and just go on. And you can see immediately.
So what do you mean by that?
It's
like,
just easier.
So you're saying spritz on water first and then go?
No, this is just two different ways.
Okay.
You want to get
you like this way better.
You want to get this nice and damp. Yes, I was just showing you can use this. There'll be times when it's maybe a small area that you just
mm-hmm.
use this. It's up to you. You're going to get a feel for which you prefer.
And so I'm asking these questions legit, not just because I think you guys want to know. It's because I'm still learning to use the inlays, and I'm really excited to dive deeper and start using more. So I'm actually really asking these questions. Hello, Mandy from Australia. Yay. And Helga is from Alberta, Canada. You must know our Annie.
Oh, yeah.
Annie's here, too.
Oh,
hello,
hi, Annie.
Annie.
Our Annie.
She's our Annie.
All right. I think we are nice and damp.
Okay.
Just gonna, sometimes you want to wait like half a minute, 15 seconds or so, before you start to pull. Oops. You know what?
We didn't get the edges. Here, I'll do it.
Round. Okay. And yeah, just set it and do the same over here. Let's pay attention to that second shot and make sure I don't block anything.
You're good.
Okay.
So far, so good.
Nice.
Okay. And then do we brayer it at all?
And here's the thing, too. We don't need to brayer it. No.
Okay.
You don't want to overwork those fibers. So get have this nice and damp. So you're just laying that coat of water on there and letting it absorb. Okay. Mm-hmm. You don't want to be rubbing it too much and stuff because you can start to break down the fibers. And you know you can get more than one use out of the IOD.
Break down the fibers of the paper.
Right. Okay. Exactly. So you want to handle it with care. And now see here how, guys, how that comes off with very little... Let me see. Can they see?
Let's go from that way.
Okay. Let's go from this way.
Yeah,
great idea.
Direction. So this. Hold on. There we go. Okay. Keep going.
Okay. So this.
This is the best part. I want to make sure.
In fact, let me do this.
There we go.
And then even get in. Oh, yeah. There we go. Okay, so this is how much tension you should, and if it starts to stick anywhere, you're going to stop. Okay, so I feel a little more tension.
Can we just have a moment? I want you guys to just understand. This is paint, as if you took a tiny paintbrush and artistically painted the design by yourself. There's no difference. It is paint. Paint on paint. So let that soak in, let that speak to your artist self and all the things that means for you. Yes. All the things that means in terms of techniques and how you're going to use this. So just wanted to say that.
It's true. And when you put your hands on these, and like we said, like, go in.
Look at that.
If you're nervous, we get it. You don't want to waste money. So go on a pack with a friend or two and get pieces of it and play with smaller pieces.
And some stockists will give you a sample to just play with. Doesn't hurt to ask.
Exactly.
They are kind of precious, so don't be mad if they don't do that.
So here we go. Now.
Oh, yes. Thank you. Yes,
I kind of want to get in closer for a minute.
Okay, do you want me to take it off and zoom?
Take it
and
off.
And kind of follow you. Just get a better angle.
Yeah, I do, but this is so nice how it's not shaky.
Wow.
I know. So who remembers, if you've watched other inlay tutorials, what we do with this? What do we do with this, guys? Do we discard it?
Do we? What do? Do we discard it?
We lay it flat. Face paint side up. You can see, let's get in closer so that you can see the difference between.
Keep it, Cassandra.
Yes.
Thank you.
You keep it, put it in a flat spot to dry, face side up, because baby, you're going to use this again.
Yeah. In fact, we might be using these again very soon on our next live. We are already thinking about what project we want to do with those papers. And you can actually get, I mean, honestly, it depends on what look you're going for, but you can get like three solid uses out of these sheets. And there are so many sheets. So you could do like three pieces of furniture in a bunch of smalls. They go a long way, you guys.
They really do.
Keep that in mind.
Okay, so now I mentioned before that you need to be aware when you're applying water if you've exposed a panel, right? So I want to make sure that I'm damp enough over here.
I don't want
to get water here. So I'm just going to be aware of my edge.
And keep it. You just want to keep that wet.
Yeah, I just want to make sure that it doesn't
dry.
When it dries, it'll start to regrip a little bit.
Yep. Once you get the hang of this, this may sound complicated, but really it's not. We're over explaining so that you guys have the tools that you need to get the best finish.
Okay, so
but once you start playing with it, it's like anything else. You totally get the hang of it.
I do. I want to take this off and get closer, sis, because it's so satisfying.
So
and every single time
pretty.
It feels the same. Like,
it is. It's so pretty.
Here's the thing. Okay, put that on there, sis.
This makes me so happy.
Here's
gonna
the
go
thing.
In my home.
This is different than transfers, and transfers obviously will never dishonor transfers 100%. However,
transfers definitely have their benefits.
Like, yes,
once and done, easy, no
totally.
Mess.
Totally. But
for the artist in you, and you all have the artist in you, the ones that tactile feeling that is different with paint than it is putting a transfer on, you're going to feel this. The experience and the pleasure of using something that
are
is
you,
on
are
the
you
organic.
Getting
Stop. It's so anyways, you do, and
I love it.
I appeal to you. Get your hands on a sample and play with it with no worry. Do sample boards and just play with it and get the feel for it, because the artist in you is going to thank you and love you, because this is paint on this organic, beautiful paper, and you're gonna love it. Set this aside.
Kim has a GateLink table in her stash, and she's like, now I know what I'm gonna do with it.
Okay.
Oh, that's so pretty. Okay, I'm gonna get a better shot over here as you're peeling.
Oh, good idea.
Save that, my boy.
Set that right over there. And now. And there's just one last open piece.
Oh my goodness, it's so pretty.
Right there.
I'm actually glad I did a Gen 1. So let me, I'm just calling it that. I don't know that that's the official name of it, but the first time you use the sheets, the pattern is bold and it is solid and it is darker. And I thought, oh, I really wanted to do a Gen 2 with this second use of the sheets because I wanted kind of a distressed look on this pattern. But now I'm loving it just like this. So there's another way to get that. You can seal it and then give it a light sand. You do not want to sand it before you've sealed it. So we're going to seal it and then sand it. But
yes.
I'm loving this just as it is. But the Gen 2, you can also get that look and then still seal it. You definitely want to seal it every time you use the paint inlays because it is active paint.
Right.
So you definitely want to seal it. It's not, not a transfer. So you need to seal it just like a precious painted design that you want to keep.
Imagine you were painting, because this is a proprietary artist quality paint medium that we made specifically for our market and for decorative artists.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine that you were painting with a watercolor or a gouache, a traditional gouache. You would seal that when you were done with it in order to keep it from reactivating, because those tend to be reactivatable as well.
Exactly.
Just like that.
Now, reactivatable?
Reactive. Water reactive. She's really taking liberties on her birthday, isn't she?
We need to start our own dictionary.
So what we have here, and the first thing you're going to do before you go on with a brushed-on sealer, in most cases, and you'll see on our 101 videos as well as our packaging, there's different ways to do it. But our go-to way right now is a diluted mix of water and your water-based sealer, 50-50, or even more water than that, depending on the sealer, how thick it is. And you're going to put it in a nice fine mister bottle, and you are going to do a couple of light coats all over the surface. You could also use a rattle can water-based sealer that you can get, but a lot of times, because our stockists are doing classes and you're working indoors, doing something from a mister bottle is good as far as fumes and stuff.
Yeah.
And then after that's thoroughly dry, you can go on with your favorite brush-on sealer and or top coat.
Right.
So
could you sand? I was going to ask you this earlier. Can you sand after this spray coat, or should you wait until this painted on sealer?
That is a great question. You can sand after this. And as long as you go on thoroughly, it's all about encapsulation of the pigments. So like if I went on with one light coat of this, and then I sanded, I could probably break through that encapsulation and get a little migration. But if I did two thorough coats of this, let it thoroughly dry in between and after, and then knocked it down, probably going to be good to go. And then I would like to, if I'm using sanding in those steps, I like to do one more to encapsulate it before I go on with my brush.
And what she means by paint migration is the paint could smear because it's still
pigment.
It's
reactive until it is thoroughly sealed.
Correct. I just wanted to address, Colleen asked, would you call this generation 3 for the paint and lace? I think I confused you by using the term gen, first gen. I'm using an old stamping term. When you stamp once and then you stamp again, it's called second gen. So I'm referring only to the application of the sheet, how many times it's been applied, Colleen. So each time you apply it, the pattern is a little bit more broken. A little bit, it pulls the character from the first project that you did, the second project, and then by the third project, you're getting a lot of character, a lot of texture, a lot of just brokenness in the pattern. It's so beautiful, just different. So that's what I mean by first, second, third gen. This is a first gen. We are putting this sheet on for the very first time, and you can see that by the way the pattern is bold and unbroken and
yes.
clean. It's very, very clean. So that's what I am referring to.
The second generation
mm-hmm.
impression that we get will be like, for example, from this, and you'll
mm-hmm.
get a like a more of a periwinkle blue.
Mm-hmm.
And it's so fun because depending on the colors you go on in your first use, some of the pigment
yeah.
from the base coat that you use will be transferred to your paper and then to your subsequent project.
It's super fun, you guys. It's
it
like
is.
It's kind of like you're pulling that little toy out of the Cracker Jacks box. For those of you that remember Cracker Jacks, you don't know what you're going to get. So it's kind of fun not having full control
yeah.
and just going on and not, but it's always, always beautiful.
It's
every
gorgeous.
Time that we've done it, second generation,
like,
third generation, it's like, what's it going to be? What's it going to be? And
yeah.
it's honestly, every time it's stunning and it takes our breath away.
It
and
is.
So you guys are going to have so much fun with these.
You are. It's every time I look at them like, oh, I could not have figured out how to plan that out and achieve that, like if I was
right.
doing it on purpose
exactly.
or doing it with more control.
Yes.
So
yes.
It's
that's fun, just kind of chippy, painty, vintage.
Yeah.
I mean, you guys are going to love it. It's right up your alley. It's what speaks to us, right? So you're going to love it. Thank you, G.
We've got that sprayed with a setting coat.
Okay,
that-
good question. Irene said, why doesn't it run the paint when it's right.
Oh, because it's stable enough and it's dry. Now, if we had taken just water without the finish, because the finish has binders in it, that as it makes contact and dries, those binders are more stable than the water, for example. But if I just took water and I sprayed it, let it dampen, and then sprayed it again, I could get a little bit of drippy.
Mm-hmm.
But you can also, and we've got, well, I won't tell you about all the techniques we've got lined up, but you could take like a hanky brush.
Indigo.
Okay, guys. Sorry about that. My phone just like exited out of the blue. So can you guys hear us now? Yes, technical difficulties. Still no sound?
Oh, it's showing sound on here.
Okay.
Let me just go to the mic. Oh. No?
No, no.
No mic, okay.
No. Can you guys hear us? Okay, thumbs up.
Yes, okay.
They can hear us.
Awesome. Okay. Okay.
That would be sad to have to end it that way.
Now, what were we saying?
We were talking
You can, with a soft brush.
Hickey brush.
Like a hickey brush. Yeah. You can mist it, let it set for a second, and then go in and dapple it, and you can pull some of that pigment out, and almost like a flow blue in this case. Mm-hmm. We have another, like, amazing technique that we're preparing a tutorial for you guys on that you're going to love, having to do with the same thing, ways to really play and open up the potential for the reactive nature of the inlays. So
yes,
we're preparing things for mm-hmm. you mm-hmm. Right around the corner.
Somebody asked, can you give us any news on new releases, pretty please?
It never fails.
I know.
You guys.
You sneaky. All we can say is that there is one, and you will be informed soon and subjective, I know.
Right.
Or
we are
subjective.
Being, and I know you guys know this already, and we hate this. We have to be extra strategic in our communication about the releases because logistics.
Things change with the ports and everything where they are. Things change
are
constantly.
Great.
And so we have to and want to honor our stockists in making sure
being careful
that they put their best foot forward when they're presenting them to you. So we don't want to make promises they can't keep.
So, exactly.
We're not going to give any dates or anything like that. Just know that it's coming and it's amazing. You guys are
yes.
going to love it.
Troubleshooting.
Soon like tomorrow. No. I can't tell you that. It is not soon like tomorrow.
Okay, let's see. Somebody said eight sheets to a pack. Troubleshooting when the paper won't release. If the paper won't release and you've used a mineral type, chalk type paint with that is not heavy in polymers and it won't release, that means you need to get it more damp. Give it a little more dampness mm-hmm. and let it set for a moment and then pull. Because like I said, it should never be so much tension that it feels like it could tear. Now this is a special carrier paper. It's not just regular paper,
yeah.
but nonetheless.
Some people are hearing about the paint inlays for the first time. So I want to make sure that we cover what Josie's talking about when she says heavy in polymers. So the paints, you talk about it.
Well, you really should, if you want to, and we sure hope you do,
watch
get
the 101.
With these, you need to watch the 101 because we cover all that stuff in the 101 video. And we also have comprehensive
yeah.
instructions on the back of the packaging.
The short version of that, though, is you do need to pay attention to the paint you're using with the
yes.
inlays.
And always.
They work with a ton of paints.
Yes.
Base coat paints I'm talking about.
But like you're not going to use latex paint, for example.
Right.
You're not going to use paints that are heavy in polymers. However, for your standard application like we just did. However, you can do off-label use and put them in a clear coat, okay?
Mm.
Clear coat is not chalk-based. It does have polymers. Your timing is crucial when you do that because if you let it like this, we could take it off a week from now and it would be fine. It would release. But if it were a type of paint or coating that had polymers in it, their job is to bind and hold on, right? So in a week, you're going to have a mess.
Mm-hmm.
But if like right around that 20 minutes or so, depending on conditions, you can make it work and have really cool off-label uses. So what you're going to want to do is check out that 101 video, and you're going to want to talk to your favorite stockist because they are getting intimate with the inlays and getting ready to like just be showing you all the techniques, their favorite products to use with them, their hacks, their off-label mm-hmm. uses, all the things. Guys, this
yes.
is the next thing in our industry.
Annie, yes, we did. We used a Choctite paint for this project.
Yes.
Okay. It's not that great for chalk paint. Yes, it is actually great with chalk paint. Chalk paints do not have
mineral paints that are not heavy in polymers.
Not heavy in polymers, exactly. That's the key. Yes. Thank you, girls. Thank you, guys.
Oh, that's a great idea. Can you post the link to the 101 video? Yes, we will get the link.
I believe, yeah, we linked it in the last
we'll
live.
And great idea,
absolutely,
Annie.
If anybody is Julie or Stephanie, if you're on the live, would you post a link to the 101? There it is. I love
there
it.
There we go.
It's like magic.
Yes.
There's the link right there, guys. And you can also search paint inlays on our website. If you miss that link, you can go straight to there and look at that too. That's so pretty.
It is.
Okay, you guys. So let's move to the side so we can see this beautiful piece.
Yes.
And then we'll say goodbye.
Yes, I'm just putting this back. Don't mind me.
Beautiful.
Oh, it's all good. It's all good.
Nothing to see here.
She's ruining my birthday table. Here, move over to maybe that side. No, that's good. I don't want you right there, but I want to see you right here. Yeah. Perfect.
You're such
just
a brat.
Like that. There. Here, we'll just do this. Nadoy.
Nadoy.
Okay, there. Now you can go this side. Okay, you guys, this has been so much fun. Thank you for joining us. And again, we're going to be doing lives. And we're going to be
getting back in the swing of things.
So sorry about that. But we're not sorry. Sorry, not sorry. Yeah, you guys have an awesome week. Awesome rest of the week. Keep the comments coming and
yes,
we will continue to answer them. We're super excited about this product. We hope you guys run out, grab some from your stockists.
Who wants
and
to
play.
Try these now?
Give
guys?
Them a try.
Come on.
Okay. Bye, you guys.
Mwah.